Good day, everyone. My name is Maria Felice. I'm the product marketing manager for Screening Eagle in Singapore. Our partner in the Philippines is Shifra. Today, I'm very happy to speak to you about the non-destructive testing of heritage structures using our solutions. So Screening Eagle is a company founded in 2019. It's the merger of two companies, ProSec, which is a leading NDT manufacturer since 1954, and DreamLab, which is a software development company headquartered here in Singapore. Screening Eagle has over 200 employees in 8 country offices, including the one here in Singapore. And we have a very strong partnership network with over 200 partners in over 100 countries. So our mission is very simple. It's to protect the built world. So whatever the age of an asset, our aim is to protect it, to make it safer and more sustainable. So some challenges in doing this, starting with as-built defects. So this is when structures are built with defects inside them due to lack of quality control. The next challenge is aging infrastructure. So this is very relevant for heritage structures. And it arises when the inspection and maintenance aren't conducted properly. Third is data lost. So this is when data is locked inside instruments, standalone instruments. It's very difficult over the years to collect the data from these individual instruments. Next is paper records. So paper is often used for building drawings or inspection reports. And this can get damaged or easily lost. And finally, the shortage of inspectors. So we see this in the construction industry in some countries. And also for the heritage inspection, we see this problem in most countries. So few young people wanting to enter the industry. So how Screening Eagle tries to overcome these challenges is with our, what we call our full stack intelligent inspection ecosystem. So we combine the hardware. So we have almost 70 years experience of manufacturing NDT hardware. And we combine this with intelligent software. So most of our new products now run off apps on iPad. And the combination of the hardware and software means that our customers can conduct predictive maintenance, they can maintain digital twins, and they can manage the full life cycle of their assets. So here is a summary of some of our concrete testing products. So these are the most relevant for heritage structures. We do also have products for other materials like metal, but today I will just cover our concrete testing portfolio. So on the left, the most basic and cheapest inspection method is visual. And we can do this using our Inspect app. Then moving to the center, we have vital signs. So this is similar to checking the temperature or blood pressure of a patient. So a bit more advanced than visual, but still pretty straightforward. And for concrete, we have Resipod for measuring resistivity, Schmidt for measuring the strength, Pundit ultrasonic pulse velocity for measuring uniformity and homogeneity. And finally, our latest product, which is Pundit impact. So this is for checking the thickness. And on the right, you can see our more advanced sensors. So these actually conduct imaging. So we can really see inside the structure and see if any objects are present, such as pipes, and importantly, if there are any defects present. So for that, we have ultrasonic imaging using Pundit array, ground penetrating radar, which uses radio waves, and profimeter, which uses eddy current. So as mentioned before, we combine the software with the hardware sensors, and the combination of these two tools enables people to maintain digital twins. So some people perhaps are not at that stage yet, but our tools enable them to start working towards this aim. So maybe to give an example, especially for a heritage project, what this actually means for a project step by step, what you do. So the first would be to understand your objective. So typically this is to understand the condition of your structure, if there are any defects present, and importantly, then to determine what repair works need to be done. It's also important to have 2D and 3D drawings. So often these are not available or not available in detail for heritage structures. So we can use our modern tools to get these 2D drawings and 3D models. We can also use equipment to geolocate the structural elements, so to understand exactly where they are in the physical world. Then we move on to condition assessment of the structural elements, so seeing if they're still structurally sound and safe. And we use a variety of our NDT tools for this. And finally, the tool which brings everything together is using a cloud-based ecosystem. And I will talk about this in detail. So having a system whereby all the objectives, the results, the plans, everything can be stored in one place, on one device, and then backed up on the cloud so that it is secure and can be accessed from other locations. So if we look at some features of our Eagle Inspect platform, this works on an iPad, so it's an iPad app. The first is precise location. So here you can see we set up a new project depending on the location or the structure that we're testing. And then we can use 2D plans as a starting point. And then any photos or anomalies or anything that we see will be assigned to positions on this plan. So whenever we assign something to our structure, we call this a spot, be it a photo or a defect, anything that we notice and want to record, we call this a spot. So here you can see, for example, on a bridge, we mark a location, a spot, and then we take a photo of this place and save it. And the template can be customizable. So depending on what you're inspecting, you can choose what fields the inspector needs to fill in. And here's another example inside a tunnel. The next feature is very important for heritage structures. So this is the 3D scan. So with the latest iPad models, there is LiDAR technology incorporated. So we can use this to scan our building, just walk around, you know, lifting the iPad up and down, and you can scan the building or the structure, whatever it is, and then generate a 3D model. And then this 3D model can be used as your starting point. So you can apply your spots, anything you notice, onto this 3D model. And this is also useful for people who are doing BIM. The next feature is artificial intelligence defect analysis. So again, just using the iPad, we take a photo if we suspect a crack is present. And then the app does segmentation to separate the crack from the rest of the image. And finally, sensor add-ons. So Inspect is the one app which brings all our other products, our sensors together. So if you, for example, do a Schmidt rebound test at a location, you can also save this data at a spot on your Inspect app. And the same for all our other products. And then with Inspect, you have a dashboard where you can view a summary of your defects or of the condition of the structure, and also very easily generate PDF reports. So now if we look at some of the NDT sensors, the first is ultrasonic pulse echo testing. So our brand name for this is Pundit Array. So you can see here, this device has many transducers which transmit and receive ultrasound. This is connected wirelessly to an iPad. So all the setup, the processing, visualization, everything is done on the iPad. And you can see here, it's a simple handheld device used especially for detecting any defects. So it's very good at picking up any air within the material. It's also useful for measuring the thickness of a structure if there is no access to the other side. The next is ground penetrating radar. So this uses radio waves, so it's particularly good for picking up any metal within our structure. So we actually have three products at ProSec which can do this. And you can see here in the bottom right an example. This is a very large rebar mesh. So maybe in heritage structures, if they are particularly old, they won't have any rebar inside, but this can be used for detecting other materials. So if for example, the structure is made of stone and there's another material present inside, it's easy to detect this. And you can see here some examples. So this is at the Zagreb Cathedral in Croatia. So some researchers from the University of Zagreb did an inspection of the cathedral using GPR. And this is another project happening in Spain. And again, they're using our GPR products, this time to inspect mosaic. So very old Roman mosaic floors. This is another type of ground penetrating radar. So now the frequency is much lower. So it allows us to look deeper in the ground. So an application for heritage structures would be if there were buried structures in soil, for example, you could use this technique to detect them. It's also used in maybe more common examples for finding utilities in urban areas. And finally, to summarize, I will play a short video about our technology.
How great would it be if I could connect my iPad using apps to advanced inspection sensors like GPR or ultrasonics?
Excuse me, you can do that wirelessly or in restricted areas using USB.
How about adjusting all parameters while I scan?
You can do that, and it's very intuitive.
Zooming in various options to view the data?
Absolutely, and the best data in the industry.
How about large area scans and 3D visualization?
You can do that, right on site.
That's interesting. Imagine if you could actually project the data into the real world.
Well, you can do that too, using our augmented reality capabilities.
Very impressive. And how about adding tags, photos, or having a live Zoom session?
You can do all of that.
Wouldn't it be great to annotate the data with a digital pencil?
Well, you can do that too.
No way. And the same software experience for different technologies and sensors?
The same across our entire ecosystem.
How about updates with new features or adding artificial intelligence?
Absolutely. What you see today is only the very beginning of ever-evolving technology.
This is really powerful.
Agree. What else can we do for you?
And finally, a picture to end. So this is the next step for us, which is to have autonomous inspection. So you can see here a robot with our ground penetrating radar at the Zurich Opera House in Switzerland. So this is very useful for inspecting large areas and even more important when inspecting dangerous areas. So removing the human inspector. If you have any questions or want more information on anything that we've shown, you can contact us at screeneagle.com. And if you're in the Philippines, you can contact our partner, Chifra Marketing Corporation, who can help you with any technical questions. Thank you.